Good morning students, our subject is design of concrete structure 1. Our today's topic is limit state of collapse flexure flanged beam part 2. In a part 1 we already studied introductory part about flanged beam, advantages and necessity of flanged beam, disadvantages of flanged beam, three cases of flanged beam, when neutral axis lies in a flange, when neutral axis lies in a web. So in today's lecture we are going to solve some numerical examples of flanged beam. Type 1, calculation of moment of resistance. In type 1 we have to calculate mu, moment resistance mu. So example number 1, a T beam has a permissible effective flange width, means width of a flange is 500 mm. Here one T beam is given like this. Effective flange width means from here to here a width is 1500 mm. Thickness of floor slab 120 mm. The thickness of the slab is 120 mm. Width of the rib is 300 mm, means this width 300 mm. Effective depth of section from here to effective up to here, means small d, is 500 mm. Reinforced with 4 bar of 25 mm diameter, means 4 bar of 25 mm diameter is provided. Pi by 4 into d square, diameter is 25 and number of bar is 4. So from it we get a AST. Calculate the factored moment of resistance. So we have to find here mu, factored moment. Use M25 concrete, means the grade of concrete is M25 and the grade of steel is Fe415. So the grade of steel is Fe415. In this example, width of the here T beam is given, so width of flange beam is 1500, small d means effective depth is 500 and the width of rib is 300 mm. So solution, given data is here, flange width is 1500 mm, FCK is 25 MPa, AST is here 4 bar of 25 mm, so AST is number of bar is 4, pi by 4 into d, diameter is 25 square. BW means width of web or width of rib is 300 mm, effective depth is 500 mm, AST is 1963.50, DF means depth of flange, means here this depth of flange is 120 and Fy is 415, so the grade of steel is Fe415. Solution data, firstly we have to calculate here depth of neutral axis XU. So we have to find here XU. How to calculate XU? Firstly we assume that neutral axis lies within a flange, means our neutral axis lies here within a flanged, so it is equating total compression is equals to total tension. So Cu is equals to Tu. So formula is XU is equals to 0.87 Fy into AST divided by 0.36 FCK into BF. So 0.87 Fy is 415, AST is 1963.50, 0.36 FCK is 20, BF width of flange is 1500. So solving this we got XU is 52.51 mm, and our DF means this depth of flange is given here, thickness of floor slab 120, so this DF is 120 mm, so DF is 120 mm, so DF is greater than XU. XU is 52.51 and DF is 120. So our condition is fulfilled. Our condition is, or our case one is, neutral axis lies within a flange. So condition is xu is smaller than df. So xu is small because xu is 52.51 and df is depth of flange is 120. So our condition is okay. Then we find xu max. Calculation of xu max, critical depth of neutral axis. So xu max is equals to 0.48 into d. D is effective depth. Effective depth is given here. Effective depth of section is 500 mm. So effective depth we put here 500. Xu max is equals to 0.48 into d. This is for Fe415 because our grade of steel is Fe415. So formula to calculate xu max is 0.48 into d. D is at effective depth, so depth is 500. So for 0.48 into 500, so it is 240. Compare xu and xu max. We are comparing xu and xu max. So xu, in first step we find xu is 52.51 and xu max is 240. So xu is smaller than xu max. So section is under reinforced section. How to calculate section is under reinforced section, balanced section or over reinforced section? So xu is equals to xu max. It is called as a balanced reinforced section. Xu is smaller than xu max. It is called as a under reinforced section. So our xu is smaller than xu max. So our section is in under reinforced section. If xu is greater than xu max, then it is called as a over reinforced section. Now fourth step. In fourth step we have to find calculation of moment resistance mu. We have to find mu. So mu is equals to tu into z. Tu formula is 0.87 fy into ast. What is z? Z is lever arm. Z is equals to d minus 0.42 xu. So it is called as a z and it is called as a tu. So mu is equals to 0.87 fy into ast bracket d minus 0.42 xu. So we are putting values in this formula. 0.87 fy is the grade of steel is 415. Our ast, area of steel in tension side, is 1963.50. In bracket d is 500 minus 0.42. our xu is, in step number 1 we find xu is 52.51. so 52.51, so our mu is 338.83 kilo newton meter, or 338.83 into 10 to the power 6 newton mm. So in flanged beam, firstly in first step we find xu, second step we find xu max, and in third step we compare it, and in a fourth step we find mu. So we solve another example, that is example number 2. A singly reinforced T-beam. Here also T-beam is given. Following section properties, estimate the flexural strength of section using IS-456. So here T-beam is given, and for that some properties of this section is given. So width of flanged is 1250 mm. Means width of flange means, you also called it as a PF, width of flange 1250. Thickness of flange is 160 mm, means here capital DF, it is called as a thickness of flange. Thickness of web means BW, BW is 250 mm. Effective depth is 750 mm, so 750 mm is effective depth D, small d. Area of tensile steel is already given, 5000 mm square. Material M20 and Fe415, means M20 the grade of concrete and the grade of steel is Fe415. Okay, So given data here, one T section of this T section, width of flange is given 1250 mm. After that, here we provided steel. Steel is AST is equals to 5000. Okay, after that here DF is given, means depth of flange is given 160, and depth of width of web is also given here 250, and small d from here up to here, small d is equals to 750 mm. Okay, so this section is T section, width is flange of width is 1250, flange depth is 160, web thickness is 250, effective depth is 750, AST is given 5000 mm square. So we solve example. Step number 1, we have to find here neutral axis XU. Assume first case, that is first case is neutral axis lies within a flange, XU is smaller than TF. So equating total tension and compression, TU is equals to CU. The formula of CU is 0.36 FCK into BF into XU is equals to TU formula is 0.87 FY into AST. So we have to find XU. So we also write like this: 0.87 into FY into AST divided by 0.36 FCK into BF. So 0.87 FY is 415, AST is 5000 divided by 0.36, FCK is 25, BF is width of flange is 1250. So by solving this, we got here XU is equals to 200.58 mm and DF is 160. So XU is greater, XU is 200 and DF is 160. So our assumption is wrong. Our assumption is like this. So it is wrong. XU is smaller than DF. So our assumption is wrong. Our assumption is wrong. Case number 1 is wrong. It is not matched with this. So take another case. Another case is depth of neutral axis. Again we have to find XU, because our first assumption become wrong. So take another assumption. Another assumption is assuming neutral axis lies outside. Means neutral axis is here in a web. So XU is greater than DF and DF is smaller than 0.43 XU. Here two cases applied. First case is XU is greater than DF and DF is smaller than 0.43 XU. So equating total tension and compression, formula of second case is CUW plus CUF is equals to TU. Means compression of web plus compression of flange is equals to tension. So compression of web is 0.36 FCK into BW into XU plus CUF, means compression of flange is 0.45 FCK into BF is width of flange minus width of web into DF, depth of flange is equals to 0.87 FY into AST. So XU formula is 0.87 FY into AST. This we take here minus. So 0.45 FCK into BW minus BF minus BW into YF. So divided by 0.36 FCK into BW. So put value here, 0.87 FY is 415, AST is 5000 minus 0.46 FCK is 20,
in bracket BF is 1250, width of flange is 1250, width of web is 250 into depth of flange is 160 divided by 0.36, FCK is 20 and BW width of web is 250. So our first second case is XU is here 202.91 mm, so it is greater than DF. DF is 160 mm. Okay, so in this first case it is correct because XU is greater, this value is 202.91 mm, is greater than 160. So first this is correct, but DF second our case is DF is greater than 0.43 XU. This 0.43 XU is greater, but DF is 160 and our value is 0.43 into 0 XU is 202.92. So this value is 87.25. So again assumption is wrong because it is not 87.25, it is not greater than 160. So our again assumption is wrong. Then take third case. Third section is XU is greater than DF and 0.43 XU. So we again take here equating total tension and total compression. So see, you take case number 3, the formula of YS is different here. So compression of flange plus compression of web is equals to tension. So 0.36 FCK into BW into XU plus 0.45 FCK into BF into minus BW into 0.15 into XU plus 0.65 into DF is equals to 0.87 FY into AST. So formula to calculate XU is 0.87 FY into AST minus 0.45 FCK into BF minus BW. Here this value is of YF. So this value is 0.15 into XU plus 0.65 into DF divided by 0.36 FCK into BW. So we put here values in this formula. So 0.87 FY is 415, AST is 5000 minus 0.45 into FCK is 20, BF is 1250, width of flange is 1250, width of web is 250 into 0.15 XU. We have to calculate here XU. 0.65, DF is 160 divided by 0.36 into 20 into 250. So how to solve this example? Firstly solve this 0.87 into 415 into 5000 minus 0.45 into 20 bracket 1250 minus 250. So into multiply by XU plus 0.65 into 160. So this value of XU is take plus here. So we divided by 0.36 FCK is 20 and BW is width of web is 250. So XU value is 275.95 mm and our DF is 160. Our assumption is XU is greater than DF. So our XU is 275.91, so it is greater. So our first case is okay. Second case is DF is greater than 0.43 XU. Our XU is 275.95 into 0.43. So our XU is 160 and our 0.43 into XU is 160. So assumption is correct here. DF is greater than, so assumption is correct, DF is greater than 118.66. so our assumption is correct. In third case we got here XU. because in first case we assume that our neutral axis is lies in a flanged, it is fail. In second case we assume our neutral axis is lies in a web, but xu is greater than df, but we take df is smaller than 0.43 xu, then again in this case it is failed. So we take another case number 3, xu is greater than df, but df is greater than 0.43 xu, so our assumption here is correct. Now we take here 3 cases. If in first case your assumption is not correct, then you have to find these 3 steps. So second step here, we have to calculate xu max, critical depth of neutral axis, it is called as a xu max. So our xu max is equals to 0.48 into d. Why we take this formula 0.48 into d? Because our grade of steel is Fe415, because of that we take 0.48 d. So our depth is, effective depth is 750, so 0.48 into 750, that is 360. Compare xu and xu max, which xu max we have to take in third. So here third step is compare xu and xu max. Our xu is 275.95. in a third case our assumption is correct, so take a third case of xu is 275.95 and xu max is 360, so xu is smaller than xu max, xu max is greater, so section is under reinforced section. Now second, moment of resistance, we have to find here moment of resistance, the formula to calculate mu. So by using in third case to calculate mu is Cuw into Z plus Cuf into Z2. What is Cuw? Compression in web into Z is lever arm, plus Cuf is compression in flange into Z2. So mu is 0.36 fck into xu into bw minus d minus 0.42 xu plus 0.45 fck in bracket bf minus bw into yf minus in bracket d minus yf by 2. What is yf? Here yf value is 0.15 into xu plus 0.65 df. So 0.15 xu is 275.95 plus 0.65 df is 160, so yf is 145.39. so put this value in above formula. 0.36 fck is 20, xu is 275.95, here bw is 250, in bracket d is 750 minus 0.42, xu is 275.95 plus 0.45 into fck is 20, in bracket bf is 1250 minus bw is 250 into 145.39 is our yf. So yf is 145.39, in bracket 750 is our d minus yf is 145.39 by 2. So our mu is 1201.22 kilonewton meter, or 1201.22 into 10 to the power 6 newton mm. So in today's lecture we calculate moment of resistance by using 3 cases, case number 1, 2, 3. By using the 3 cases, we find firstly xu, then xu max, and then mu. So anyone having doubt in today's lecture, you can put your question in chat box. Okay, thank you.